हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल. माय नेम इज़ पायल एंड आई एम बैक विद अनदर रीडिंग. थैंक यू सो मच फॉर ऑल योर पेशेंस. लेट्स सी व्हाट आर द मैसेजेस फॉर यू फ्रॉम द एंजल्स, स्पिरिट गाइड्स, फ्रॉम योर हायर सेल्फ. व्हाट डू यू नीड टू नो इन दिस मूवमेंट. ओके, सो यू कैन कीप एन इंटेंशन फॉर योर सेल्फ. आई एम कीपिंग एन इंटेंशन फॉर यू दैट वॉट एवर इज दैट यू नीडेड टू लिसन टूडे, you will be getting the message for yourself. Before I start, I would also like to thank each one of you for all the love, support, patience, feedback for all my previous videos, all the clients who have taken readings, thank you so much. All the subscribers, thank you so much. People who have shared the video especially, thank you so much. And let's start the reading. Also, before I will be putting the timestamp below, so you can skip to the timestamp where you have selected your set of cards. Remember, this is a general reading. You may resonate, you may not resonate. Take whatever is for you and leave the rest. Okay? So you have to select from three different sets. First is this brown candle. Okay? The fragrance is very, very beautiful. I love this. Yes. Okay? It's odd night candle. Brown candle. Second is this lavender, which is French lavender, again very beautiful smell. Third is vanilla caramel. Wow. Okay. The smell is very, very beautiful. I hope and I wish I could send you the smell also or the fragrance also, but I can't. But hopefully the message will reach to you. So this is vanilla caramel. So you can just close your eyes, take a deep breath in and relax yourself. Don't be, don't push yourself. Don't select on the basis of color. Trust your instinct and you will be guided towards your message, okay? So let's start with the first candle, which is this brown candle. Let's see. So what is the message that group one people has to understand today? Okay, wow, I'm already loving the energy. So very first card is partnership. Okay, it says teamwork will give you a better result. Find trustworthy people to partner with, build up a talented support team. So this first card tell me two things. One is, of course, this can be partnership with regards to your work, that you need to team up with people to get the better results. Don't try and do everything on your own. Trust people or declare in the universe that only trustworthy people or partners come in your life. Of course, if you are looking for a venture or a business that you want to start, you can also declare in the universe that allow only trustworthy people to come in your life, and this will also help you to expand your horizons. This also says build up a talented support team. See, if you want to grow, you cannot do everything on your own. Drop the idea of doing everything on your own. You have to connect with like-minded people who also have the same passion, talent, or maybe sometimes I also believe that maybe they are more talented than you. Why? Because when you meet or connect with people who have more talent, patience, or any other attributes than you, it always, you know, help you to complete that project or that work or anything that you want. Okay, this also tells me that there is lot of scope to learn and grow. This also tells me that that person whom you are looking for is already on the way. You don't need to do anything. If you have already declared that, just have patience. Do not rush. Do not try and push yourself. Again, I'm saying that teamwork will give you better results. Maybe you are a kind of person who learned or who have learned in the past that, you know, you have to do everything on your own, means you want somebody, but at the same time you have an experience that it's better to work on your own. So drop that idea. If possible, connect with people. I'm just picking up the energy. Okay, I also feel that of course this is for the relationship part, partnership, like you and your partner belongs to one team. It doesn't matter you are in a relationship or you are not in a relationship. If you are not in a relationship, then you have to declare in the universe that you find the partner where you both are from the same team. If you are already in a partnership, just see where you and your partner are not acting like a team. Okay, this is that don't blame the partner that, oh, I am doing everything, but the other person is not doing. So how can I become a team? If you have a partnership or a relationship which is complicated, the universe and the unicorns are telling you that you need to see within what is stopping you to become that team member. Okay, this tells me, because the next card is forgiveness. It says, I acknowledge that harboring resentments block the flow of love. So maybe there are some resentment which is blocking you to connect with the like-minded people. As I was saying, maybe from the past experience, you have been doing everything on your own. And now the angels and the spirit guide are saying that you don't need to do that. You can always connect with people who can help you to, expand if it is with regards to work. And if it is with regards to relationship also, it is helping you to experience love, harmony, probably lot of, I also feel lot of joy, I can feel that joy in this partnership that you are attracting, or you want to enjoy that joy in your relationship. But forgiveness or the non-forgiveness and resentment is stopping you to experience. Now this forgiveness can be also towards yourself, that you are not able to forgive yourself for something. So if it is you whom you are not able to forgive, then please let go, because if you are holding back guilt brings punishment, and you don't need to punish yourself. You deserve all good in life. Okay, if it is with other person, this can be about past experiences with the same person or with different person, or even in some cases with your parents or your parents' experiences. They are urging you to let go. So just see who is that person whom you are not able to forgive. And if you are already doing forgiveness, then this is an assurance, because you are already attracting a partner, as I was saying, who is coming towards you with regards to work or with regards to your relationship, because you have worked on yourself, because you have forgiven yourself and the other people in your space. So you are creating space for better people. See, the third card is declutter. This is from Angel of Abundance deck. It says, you will feel better and more focused if you will take the time to clear away the clutter from your living and workspace. Donate what you can to help others who may need your items. Be safe to keep your schedule uncluttered as well. So give away things that you don't want. Also, you can throw things that you don't want. This can be physical decluttering, this can be emotional decluttering, workspace decluttering, or your home space decluttering. Let go of things that is not serving you. This may also be some people who are not playing that role that they are also supposed to play in your space. So because the card has come with the partnership, okay, if you feel the person whom you are dealing with in any area of your life, if you feel you are the one who is only giving in the relation, whether it is work or whether it is your relationship, you need to reevaluate that. You need to take a step back. You need to see what is that is stopping you to experience that good in your relationship with that person or with that work environment. Okay, so you need to declutter, you need to sit with yourself. If you are already doing that, then again this is an reassurance that you are on the right path. Then it says, surrender to inner peace. So cultivate inner peace on a daily basis in quiet meditative moments. Focus on the stillness within and enjoy this inner refuge. Others will feel your good vibes too, and your life will flow more easily. So I understand the card which has come forgiveness is very much related to this surrender to inner peace. Because when you are doing forgiveness, you are not doing forgiveness because they were right. You are not doing forgiveness because the experience has no importance in your life. You are not doing forgiveness because it was not painful. You are only doing forgiveness because you deserve peace. You are doing forgiveness because you need to be free. You are doing forgiveness because you deserve all good in life. Okay? So when you surrender to your inner peace, you cultivate this habit, a daily habit, you will see that your vibrations are shifting. You will see that people are being replaced. Either they are replaced or either the people in your space are changing. See, when we do forgiveness, only two things can happen. First thing is either they will shift, or second thing is they will leave your space peacefully. And believe me, if they leave your space, you will be not affected, because they will be replaced with better people in your life. So suppose if there is a job situation where you are struggling, you do forgiveness and trust your inner guidance, trust your inner peace, and see what should be your next step. See, this is a general reading, so I would not say just give up your job. I am saying that step back, see what is stopping you, do the forgiveness. If you are the one who is doing everything in the work and you are still not getting the returns, then you need to seriously think over why you are entertaining toxicity in your space. If you feel that my ego was holding me back, because many times our ego says that I am right, okay? And that, feeling of I am right doesn't allow you to grow. And just also check from the tarot deck, actually what is that is you need to let go, or which you need to forgive, okay? Let's see what is that. Because here I'm getting 2-3 scenarios. As I already said one, let's see. Or I said two, I guess. So let's see more. What is they want to say for you? What do you need to let go? What do you need to forgive? See, justice card. Justice, when it comes with forgiveness, it tells me the justice will be served. You don't need to, punish anybody. You don't need to go in the energy of revenge. You don't need to go in the energy where you need to prove your point. You need to believe in the justice, in the divine. They are already going to serve the justice. You need to trust. Okay, if you see the card, her eyes are closed and her eyes are open. Close your eyes, go within, and let your inner guidance guide you. Okay? Justice will be served. Wow, Six of Wands. See, you are expanding, you are being appreciated by the universe, even by other people in your space, even, I feel some cases, even by your parents. And this also tells me that you are going to be appreciated and being followed by many people also. If you see, there are many hands, like she is on a stage, right? And there are many hands like waving at her, and she is opening to the universe and declaring that she is open to receive, right? Because this openness will help you to connect to that divine power and help you to be more receptive. You are already coming in this energy. And because you are forgiving and you are surrendering to inner peace, of course, you are also decluttering. And then it says King of Wands. So one is, of course, there may be some male person that you need to forgive. One thing. This can also mean that there may be a male coming in your space soon who will help you and guide you because of this partnership card. See, now this can be, if you are a female listening to this, then it may be you have to forgive some male in your space. Because specifically if it is your father, because the minute you do that forgiveness, you are surrendering to the universe, plus you are shifting your cellular memories, you are replacing it with healthy cellular memories, like you are replacing and you are creating space for healthier cellular memories. so that cycle gets over, the past cycle gets over, and you get into this healthy relationship. So this person can be a fire sign coming in your space. Yes, a very leader kind of person, very attractive. He knows what he is doing. And here also there was six of wands. So either it can be an air sign also or a fire sign. Let's see what is coming. Wow. As I was saying, you are completing a cycle, death and rebirth. You are completing a cycle and you are coming in the new cycle. So trust your path. Okay, two major arcanas in the single reading is a very good sign. And death is not always about bad. Death is also about, ending something and starting something new. Let's see if there is anything else that is coming. Also, I feel maybe you are dealing with a person who is Leo, or you yourself is a Leo sign. So, okay, I think this is it for set one. People who have selected brown candles. Just trust the process. New partnership coming in your space. And do forgiveness towards yourself and others. Also, this says be appreciate yourself and appreciate others more. Even your journey, so that you create more space for better. This person can be fire sign. Also be very passionate towards growing or expanding your work, or if you want to attract a partnership. Okay, so this was your reading. Thank you so much. Lots of love to you. We will meet in some other time and space. Bye. Let me know in the comment section how did you found the reading. Let's go to the next set of cards. People who have selected this lavender candle. Hello group 2. Welcome back to my channel. Let's see what is the message. Wow. So I think if you were confused between two set of cards, 1 and 2, probably you can also check 1 if you want to. The reason is the message is quite similar. The first card there was partnership and here is beloved. And it says, prayer for your life partner, romance is returning to your relationship, believe you are lovable. So okay, this is very clear message that you are getting into a relationship, or your current relationship is improving. This says that the universe is preparing you for the life partner, and the changes you are making in your life is also helping you to prepare you for the partnership. This says that maybe you have some struggle with regards to your low self-worth or low self-esteem, which is also stopping you to experience a beautiful relationship. So give away that low self-esteem, low self-worth, because it is coming from the past experiences. Your new experience will be not the same. You will definitely have a different kind of experience, and this experience is actually bringing lot of change. And because I feel, I'm just picking up the energy that maybe that in the past you have experienced relationships which were either toxic or which were not serving the purpose. And that is only because it was coming from either from the past life, which is karmic connections, or you may have to complete some lessons and cycles with the person, or this could be you in your childhood you had some bad experiences. But in this second phase of your life, definitely things are changing. The message is, I understand that nothing can grow or evolve without movement. Okay, so they are saying that you need to move more. Either you have to move your body, either you have to move your consciousness, like you have to shift your consciousness. I feel you are already shifting. This also tells me that you have understood one thing somewhere down the line, that you want a better partnership, or you want a better situation in the current partnership. So when you have understood this, allow the universe to give it to you. That is the reason it said that prepare for your life partner. Okay, this also says that change is inevitable. So you are safe in the process. You don't need to worry that what this new changes will bring. See, whenever we have been into a bad relationship or a bad situation from the past, it happens many times that we have this trauma response towards the situation, and that excites, you know, subconsciously it excites somebody who has been through so much, because it was like they are, you know, it keeps them engaged in the relationship, okay? But now, because you are asking for a different kind of relationship where you experience love, harmony, joy, peace, you know, all that higher vibrational, definitely this relationship will not excite you probably, because it will lead you to joy, and you also have to surrender to joy. It says a key to positive change in your life is to let joy in and savor it. Indulge in random acts of smiling during both the hard and easy times. Keep surrendering to more joy. So you need to keep surrendering to more joy. You need to understand that only when you decide that I want to be joyful, you will attract a situation which will bring you joy. If you keep on focusing on something that has happened in your past and which is painful and which is not good, you will see that things are actually bringing you the same kind of results which may irritate or frustrate you. So to have a different experience, keep on surrendering to joy. Then they say quiet retreat. It's time to disconnect from the world, outer world, so that you can discern, process your true thoughts and feelings from your inner world. Create this quiet time for yourself and you will have more clarity about what to do next. So of course, because there is change coming in your life, they are asking you to go within, go on a retreat, because retreat will help you in two ways. One is it will help you to go within and understand what is actually you have to do and what you have to incorporate in your life, so that you can attract a partnership or you have to bring any kind of changes in your life. Then it also tells me that it will also help you to heal, because as I was saying, in the past you may have a very bad experience. So retreat will help you to heal, because nature has a very natural way of healing, right? Nature is something very natural, and it will come and it will help you to come into your center, which will again help you to bring that inner peace, inner joy, and a healthy partnership. Okay, let's see what else, if there is any other message. So see, nine of swords, it says maybe you have been through a lot of anxiety, you may not be able to sleep properly, or you may be worried or procrastinating or delaying your inner guidance, because maybe there is something that you already know that you have to do or you have to bring that change in your life, but because of this knight of swords energy, which is anxiety, sleeplessness, some of you may be also going a little bit of depression in a way, because things are changing, and whenever things change it may be discomfort. Okay, because see, the adjacent card is judgment, and if you see, she's praying, right? She's surrendering. Things are shifting. Judgment card is also telling me that there is change happening. Many of you are also going through the process of awakening. When we go through the process of awakening, we connect to our higher self more, we connect to the divine power, and the most important thing in awakening or in this process of awakening is you need to learn to surrender. The more you surrender, the more things fall in place. So please surrender. In your case, it's very simple, surrender to joy. Okay. Let your low self-esteem and your low self-worth be your past story. It's no more. It doesn't have any validation now. Okay. Then it has come Ace of Wands. Ace of Wands is bringing you a different energy. I'm more focusing on this third eye chakra. As I was saying that you are shifting, and maybe some of your third eye is opening. Ace of Wands is generally having more creative new ideas. Maybe when you are having this, shift your energy to this, okay, where you are creatively involved in something. Okay, go within through retreat, surrender, and this will help you to change. Yes, some of you may feel little tired because the process is little slow, but you don't need to worry. Things are really going to work in your favor. See, and you may be attracting a partnership which is like King of Cups energy, very mature person. Or you may be a King of Cups. This also again tells me go within, because if you see the person is sitting in the quiet meditative mode and going within, very knowledgeable, emotionally mature person. This also says that when you are going through this change, it's very important to, you know, understand your own emotions, because once you understand your own emotions, you can always acknowledge that emotion and shift the energy or change the energy. So if in the past you were having anxiousness, you can trust the process and surrender to joy. And coincidentally, they both are wearing red. Oh, even he's wearing red. Okay, red is also the color of root chakra, and if it is quiet retreat, it will also help you, because see, retreat, you are also movement. So root chakra retreat is all telling me that you are in the process of movement, and root chakra is responsible for feeling us safe and secure. At the same time, it helps us to connect to our purpose or connect why you are on the Mother Earth, and also help you to heal. And it also helps you, means root chakra is also for our abundance or scarcity. So scarcity of love, scarcity of money, scarcity of time, energy, anything, it can shift when you surrender to joy, when you are allowing yourself to shift, when you surrender to your, I don't know, again I'm feeling inner peace, okay, though here it is not there, but inner peace, okay. And here also, if you see, there are unicorns and there are butterflies. Butterflies again represents change. And you have change card and judgment card. So I hope this reading was helpful to you. Thank you so much for coming in my space. We'll meet in some other time and space. Lots of love. Bye bye. Let's go to the next set of cards. People who have selected this vanilla caramel. I love the fragrance. Very beautiful. Hello. Let's see what is the message. Wow. So I think all three cards are connected. All three sets are connected. This is so amazing. Two different set of cards and same card is trust. Let's read the first. Leap into the unknown. Have faith and move forward. Believe you will fly. And trust, I accept that my inner voice will always guide me correctly. And if you see, the unicorn is on the edge, but and he has the wings, but he's not jumping because he's not believing that he can fly. So are you also doing that? That you understand, or you, probably you are not able to see your wings, but you have wings and you can fly. So trust the universe. Trust the process, trust your path, trust who you are. So you are a divine being. You do not need to operate from fear. Fear is stopping you to grow. Fear is stopping you to attract something good in life. Do not do that. Choose trust. Do not focus on what you don't want. Focus on what you want. If you want, make a list of things that you want and see what is the fears that you have, that things will not work out or why it will not work out, and then replace it with some positive affirmations, and do that, you know, repeatedly, or write it if possible. Also do gratitude. This will really help you to build your trust. Also acknowledge and appreciate your journey, how far you have come, so that it will help you and motivate you to how far you can go. This is really helping you to bring major shifts in your life, because they are also asking you to surrender to success. You are ready to experience abundance. Do not look back at previous roadblocks or difficulties. Leap into exciting new world of possibilities. So there is a lot of possibilities. The minute You declare in the universe that I am ready to experience different possibilities in my life, which leads to success. You will see, you will only attract that which will bring you that. But if you surrender, if you don't surrender to success, you will be not able to experience that, or it will cause delays. So if you are feeling that there are delays in your plans, in whatever relationship, marriage, work, money, you need to see where you are not able to surrender to success and where you are, you know, operating from fear, because that fear is stopping you to experience something good in life. Then they say release jealousy. Jealousy is an affirmation that you don't have something and the universe manifests exactly as you affirm. Let other people's success inspire rather than frustrate you. If they can have it, so can you. Very self-explanatory card. They are saying that you don't need to be jealous. And if you feel you are dealing with people who are jealous with you, see, even if you are dealing with somebody, that means you also have something, some part of it in within you. So what you have to do is, you deal with your own jealousy by appreciating, or by acknowledging, by appreciating other people's success or their efforts and acknowledging your own jealousy. If you are dealing with other people's jealousy, you have to trust that their jealousy is nothing to do with your plans. They are having their own life path or their own lessons to learn and complete, which you don't need to entertain. But here I feel it's more to do with you, and jealousy is also a kind of fear that no, I will not have enough, or other people can get but I can't, and this will all cause delays. So they want you to surrender to success. Let's see what is the other messages connecting to this. And trust is one of the major lessons that you need to learn in this lifetime, and this is what I feel, because that is the reason you are facing many obstacles in whatever you plan or if whatever you want to do. The reason is universe has made, or you have made a contract with universe in this lifetime to learn about trust. So it's like taking that leap of faith. It's like if you want that, maybe your conversation, your inner dialogue is, if this will happen, I will be happy, or if this will happen, I will do this. You should have the conversation which is other way around, that I am doing this and I am trusting that universe will make it happen for me. And suppose if it doesn't happen still, then you have to believe that there is some lesson, there is something that universe is trying to make you understand, or that is where the path is. It's like your path goes through that tunnel which you feel that it is all dark. No, there is light at the end of the tunnel. Or you are the light which has to cross through that tunnel. Wow, this is so beautiful. So of course, one of the major thing that is coming towards you is relationship. That is, I think, common theme for all the three cards today. 10 of cups is a very beautiful energy of attracting good partnership in your life, and you are going to attract that. Okay, you are in the process of attracting that, or if you are already in a relationship, you are going to experience a beautiful partnership with your person. I don't know, I'm feeling like if you are looking for having a child, then there is also a possibility. If you are already, you want to have a children, then there is a possibility, but you have to choose trust. Do not go in fear. Another message is Page of Swords. Pay attention to what you say, the inner dialogue that you have, because Page of Swords is all about communication. You may be very good with communication, but see the book in her hand, and the bulbs is telling me pay attention to what you read, what you say, what you listen, whom you believe. They are all trying to guide you, and because whatever you say, you are actually manifesting that in your world. And then Queen of Wands. So the first set of cards had King of Wands, and here it is Queen of Wands. It may be connected. The Queen of Wands energy is all about coming in your true power. Believe that you are attractive. Believe that whatever you set your mind to, you will manifest. Like this wand in this hand, she is like creating a magic. Okay, so you can create that magic in your life because you are that magic. Maybe you have forgotten that and universe is reminding you. And then back card is four of wands again, beautiful relationship, partnership or friendship coming in your way. Let's see. Yes, some of you may have fear of success or fear of you want that, but at the same time you are having a fear that what will happen if this will manifest. So let go of all your fears, ground yourself, connect to earth, that will also help you. And also work on your solar plexus and sacral chakra. If you are into coloring, dancing, singing, please do some physical activity or some hobbies, that will also help you in your healing. That is what the message I am getting. You are on a beautiful journey, just believe in yourself, okay? That's what the message I am getting from here, and trust the universe and trust your path. Thank you so much, lots of love. We will meet in some other time and space. God bless you. Bye bye.